नमस्कार, लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट नक्षत्र विशाखा। वी आर गोइंग वंस अगेन विद द सेम अप्रोच टू अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ विशाखा, टू गो थ्रू द नक्षत्र मंत्र ऑफ विशाखा, टू गो थ्रू द स्टोरी ऑफ विशाखा, कवरिंग द रेमेडीज फॉर विशाखा एंड द रिजल्ट ऑफ डिफरेंट पदार्थ इन विशाखा। विशाखा means sub branches. First of all, shakha means branch, vishakha means branch of a branch. So vishakha is the third level person. So he is not your brother, no, he is your brother's brother, but quite a distant thing. That is the thing with vishakha. You know, Vishakha never comes through anything directly. It always comes through things very indirectly. There are two things related to Vishakha that I have noticed. First of all, whatever is going to happen, Vishakha will be able to sense that beforehand. Whatever is supposed to happen, Vishakha will be able to suppose it beforehand. First of all. Because once again, Vishakha is not going to confront anything directly. For many of us, like almost for all of us, things happen out of a sudden. We have no pre-information about anything happening. This Vishakha person has pre-information about things happening. So that is the blessing of it. The boon of it is, bane. The bad part of it is that many a times the Vishakha person never actually have done something or is not culprit for something, but becomes the sacrificial goat. The sacrificial goat is something that I will strongly want to specifically want to refer, the sacrificial goat. Vishakha. There is, suppose there is something that's gonna happen, or there is an, what is Vishakha? The first relationship makes you a good person always. Right, the first relationship transforms you into a good person. Right, but for the partner, who is your partner for the first relationship, for the partner it is not a very good experience, because the partner have to handle a very terrible person. That is what happens with Vishakha. Vishakha becomes the first lover of anyone. Like Vishakha is also Radha, ruled by Radha, it is told, right? So Radha is the love of Krishna, and Krishna is not that refined a person that he becomes later on. So Radha is the first love. So she have to go through all the fights of Krishna, struggle of Krishna, and living of Krishna. There's, others don't have to face that, but Radha have to. Radha have to face that separation from Krishna. That is what happens with Vishakha. Vishakha is actually not responsible for things, but he will be the sacrificial goat, the guinea pig on whom the first application will be done is Vishakha. And this thing is very disturbing as well as dramatic for Vishakha person. You know, Vishakha person goes into a bad relationship, suffers in the relationship, comes out of the relationship, and after coming out of the relationship, realizes that the person who was doing very bad with this Vishakha person actually transformed into a good being. Right? So Vishakha is more like a stimuli, or Vishakha is more like a platform which makes thing happen. That is Rutushaha. Two things. Along with this, Vishakha have a very influential and a very strong personality. Someone who is a born ruler, Vishakha, the Shakha, having many branches, or in other words, having many subordinates. So Vishakha is naturally born with the quality of business, naturally born with the quality of leadership, naturally born with the quality of rulership. Very often people come to Vishakha person for their advice. And Vishakha person does very well in their professional life also, specifically meant for business or self-employment. In whichever field the Vishakha person is, he may not be the main person, but he is the most famous person. Even if there are, you know, four students in the class and one student is Vishakha, then the student will have more fame than the teacher because Vishakha. Right? That's why it is told in the Vedic Panathan that Vishakha is ruled by Indra. So Indra have this particular power, you know. Indra sits with whatever god, or even if Indra sits in an assembly, people will first come and notice Indra, because everyone is sitting on the ground and Indra is sitting on a throne. So of course he will be the first noticed one. The first thing to be noticed in the room will be the Indra, right? That is what happens. That is what Vishakha have to signify. Understood? The imagery of Vishakha. See, Vishakha indicates a Torana. Torana, you understand? Not understand. Torana means, so whenever there is a worship, etc., going at your home, the priest will give you something made up of mango leaves. Right? Priest will give you something made up of mango leaves to put on your door. He will make a garland of mango leaves that you are supposed to put on the front door. That is Toran. Right? In marriages, etc., the front door is well decorated with flowers, etc. So all the flowers that are hanged on the upper portion of the door is Toran. That is what Vishakha indicates. That hints that this Vishakha person is very accommodating. Vishakha rarely hates anyone or is against anyone. Vishakha is very much, you know, serving the whole world, loving all kind of a personality. He is generally not very much against things, ideas or people. They are all encompassing. They are someone who actually understand that there is good in the world and there is ugly in the world. Mm-hmm. Right? Along with this, I will make one prediction with Vishakha. When Vishakha is positive, with good planets in Vishakha. Yes. So when Vishakha is good, having benefic planets, etc., many good things happen in life simultaneously, one after another, back to back. And when Vishakha is negative, having malefic planets in Vishakha, the person have to wait long for good things to happen in life. Suppose Vishakha is having Ketu or Mars or Rahu or Saturn or Sun, or Vishakha is afflicted. In that scenario, the person will keep on waiting to get married. After marriage, you have to keep on waiting to get the child. You'll have to keep on waiting so that he can purchase a car. Multiple times he will save money. He will want to go and purchase a vehicle. But every time some mishap or other will come. And he will have to wait for the right time to come. That is something that is indicated by Vishakha. And as I have been telling from since the starting of the series, that if you use your mind, you can use the significations for every planet placed in Vishakha, right? Just it will need just a little bit of practice, right? And just with a little bit of mind and modification, you can use the significations to predict result for every planet in Vishakha. And if you can't, consultation options on the website, third option. Right, home, about me, consult. The option there. Okay, coming to the mantra. The mantra for Vishakha is Indra Agniyo Vishakhe Yugani Parastat Akshman Avastat. The Lord for Vishakha is Indra Agni. Or Shakra Agni. Shakra is the name for Indra once again. It can be taken in two means. Either it is Indra and Agni both. The quality of Indra is rulership. The quality of Agni is leadership. Rulership and leadership. This person is a very good ruler and a very good leader at the same point of time. And there is a difference between ruler and leader. A ruler will rule you, will give you orders, and you are forced to follow it. A leader will be the one who will be actually concerned about your development and progress. Right? You know the corporate difference between boss and a leader. Indra is boss and Agni is a leader. Right? Mars, Agni, leader. Sun, boss. Indra. Right? That is the difference. And Vishakha have both the qualities. When Vishakha person, Vishakha can also exercise his authority as a king and can also come to a very basic level for you to help you or do anything. Getting my point? This is the thing with Vishakha. It have both the qualities of Indra and Agni. And you know, there is one trait very common with both Indra and Agni. That is, they both are characterless like anything. Both of them lives behind every woman. There is no woman that Indra and Agni have spared in the Vedic world. The same is the story that goes with Vishakha as well. I'm not saying that the Vishakha person is not faithful or etc. But the circumstances in life are as such that it leaves the person either willing or non-willing to have multiple partners. So if it is a good horoscope, then it will be like, you know, sir, before marriage, I loved this guy so much and I trusted him so much. But he was not of trust. Or anyway, here is a hint, right? This can turn to a very gruesome story. The one that came from Madhya Pradesh in recent times, I think previous to previous year. So it can convert into a very gruesome story. To a sensitive story where you will feel bad about the client, right? But whatever be the case, the multiplicity of partners or the luring behind sense objects is something that is common between Indra and Agni, and that is something that cannot be ignored. giving a remedy to you. I read a book long before, and that book gave a concept that if you want to achieve something, for example, money, take the thing that you most like and make a pledge. Like, suppose you like to eat pizza a lot. It's like, take a pledge that until and unless I earn this much money, I will not eat pizza. Then you don't do anything. You just leave it. And you constantly will start earning more money because the pizza will be in the back of your mind. Your mind works in a way. Mind is like a monkey that needs to be trained. And that is the thing for Vishakhaya. So whichever house Vishakha is in, to achieve that thing, you have to, like, you know, like, leave sexuality aside for that particular matter, right? Getting my point? Complete control over senses will reward you in the signification of that house where Vishakha is situated. Understood? You should. So Indra and Agni both. Along with this, Indra tells a part of the story with Vishakha. In one area, this person is, you know, you will see a contrasting story. In one area, this person will be highly respected, and in one area, this person will be suffering a lot, Vishakha. Highly respected in profession, terribly suffering in personal life. Enjoying personal life, terribly suffering in profession. Both the things will not come at the same point of time. And added to that, the authority of the person is greatly challenged. Vishakha indicates the story of that the person leaving his beautiful wife aside had an affair with maid. Insult to the lady. Right? That is what Vishakha does. The power and the authority is highly challenged. So this is Vishakha, the authority gets challenged, or I will interpret it in one more way. It indicates a big mistake, Vishakha. It indicates a big mistake. Suppose you are an MBBS doctor, right? But somehow, owing to some circumstances, you did a mistake to advise something wrong to your some relative of yours. Now what will happen? You know, people will start doubting that you yourself being a doctor, how you advise such a wrong thing to this person. So that things, you know, generally happen. I have seen, I know a lady with moon in Vishakha very closely. See, herself being well versed in medication, have been so careless about things that she was eating since last 2 weeks an expired medicine. You to at least are a dentist. Despite dentists are doctors, you should be aware of someone who is not into medicine, that is okay. But you are in medicine. That kind of a blunder mistake or a great mistake despite knowing everything. A great mistake just because of wrong assessment is indicated by Vishakha, specifically the Indra part of Vishakha. Regarding the Agni part, there are three things. First of all, words and deeds are different. The person will say something else, will do something else. In Hindi, we say that there's a difference between his actions and words. That is what happens, right? So they can say you that I will love you for a lifetime, but next day they will block you. Okay. Love for a lifetime ends in 24 hours. Okay, straight away. That can happen. There's a difference between. So they may say that, no, no, I don't cheat in business, but they actually can. And they actually are the one who does. Because generally, this is the problem. And when listening to the Nakshatra series, whenever I am saying this is the problem, mind it that by resolving the problem, you will get the good result of the Nakshatra, right? As simple as that. Okay. And Vishakha means branches. That means having many subordinates, etc. But other than that, it means two more things, you know. First of all, it is a person who is in way too many things. This is a person who is in way too many things. At same point of time, he is into multiple things, right? Generally, people are into one thing or two things at a time. But Vishakha have a problem that they overburden themselves with work. Getting my point? Like, if someone dies today, so what will happen for a Vishakha person? Morning time, you will get a call that Chachaji expired. Then in afternoon, you will get a call that brother fell sick. And in the evening, you will get a call that this employee met an accident. Now you have to go to three places. The funeral of Chachaji, your brother who is sick, and your employee who met with an accident. So that is what happens with Vishakha, right? Like we say, na, don't ride two boats at same time. But Vishakha have to. Vishakha have to. Vishakha can never sit and relax. The moment they get married, someone fell ill in their family. So they have to take care of new wife as well as the family member. The multiple disturbing factors present at once is the problem with Vishakha. So if Venus is there, these factors are related to marriage. When Mercury is there, these factors are related to education. When Jupiter is there, this factor is related to dharma. So when you want to, when you save some money to donate it to the temple, then out of sudden you will find that your Chachaji needs money to pay his loan. Your brother needs money to buy a bike, and your sister needs money to pay for her education. Not being able to do that, right? This is how it should be understood. Branched is one this thing. Secondly, about branched. You know, you cannot enjoy anything completely. That is another problem with Vishakha. With the very good news, there will be a bad news also, coupled with it. So either happiness or misery is branched into parts, right? So when you get a very good news, you also get a slight bad news. When you get a very bad news, you also get a slight good news. So Vishakha will never be completely happy or will completely remorse, will completely be sad, right? Even the experiences of life are divided, segregated, separated. Okay. In Indra Agniyo Vishakhe Yugani Parastata Prishmana Avastata. Yugani means the yugas. Yugani means the yokes technically. But also Yugani means the yugas also. We generally say that this person is not for this century. Because his thoughts, ideas, etc. advance higher. So that is generally the thing with Vishakha. The mentality of Vishakha, the thought of Vishakha, the way of thinking of Vishakha is way much ahead as compared to the family he is born in, as compared to the place he lives. That is something with Vishakha first. And secondly, Vishakha is greatly inspired with the thought of doing good to the person. It is a very humane person, very charitable person who actually thinks for the society and will go and step ahead for the society. Why I am adding it to Yugani? Because this is not Satyuga, and actually in reality you should do nothing for the society. But this Vishakha person will do. Things for the society, things for the betterment of the society, because his thought, his thinking, his emotions, his understanding is of the next level. Right? He will actually want to go a step out to help someone, support someone, motivate someone, etc. Okay? And Yugani means more things. You know, this person is like Kolhu ka bell, suna hai? Kolhu ka bell. So this is what goes with Yugani. Suppose a bullock, an ox is tied to a rotating wheel. So the ox cannot go farther away because there is a rope in his neck. He cannot stop because the wheel is moving. And he have to keep moving. Generally, the ox is tied to a moving cylinder. And below the legs of the ox something is kept to grind it. So the ox cannot sit, neither he can run. He have to keep on constantly moving. That is what happens with Vishakha. You love a person, you are not able to live with them. You don't like your family, but you are not able to leave them. There is an employee, you cannot afford him. But you cannot stop taking his services. That is the story with Vishakha. Right? Vishakha puts you into an uneasy situation. For Vishakha, there will be at least two or three of useless burdens in life will be at every place. Two or three useless burdens. Or in other words, what I will say, for Vishakha people, they don't direct their lives. There is someone else who will make decisions for them, and they just have to suffer the repercussions of the decision. For Vishakha people, getting my point? Someone else decided that you should get married, and now you have to handle an abusive husband because someone else wanted that you should get married. That is what happens with Vishakha, right? Someone else is taking decisions and you just have to follow that. Point one. And point two, multiple things in life you just have to do because you have to. So the husband is sitting at home and he don't want to work. And you have to work because you have two children and you don't want them to starve. Put into a situation where you cannot stop working and can neither leave it and go. You think my point? Someone else is taking the decisions and you are just suffering through the repercussions of the decision, point one. Secondly, you just have to keep on doing or keep on working. The break in Vishakha is very difficult. You are uselessly yoked to or binded to something that you cannot avoid, that you just have to go through. Vishakha person is generally, I will always say, Vishakha person is a punchback for the whole universe. All the karma and everything you have to go through because Vishakha. So, I'm pretty sure that I'm able to convey what I wanted to. Generally, what happens, I forget two, three things. But yeah. But whatever I told is like, okay. You understood. If someone else is directing the life, I'm pretty sure that I'm forgetting a point. I'm not able to find out which point I'm forgetting. Someone else is directing your life and things are yoked to you. And there's multiple responsibilities, right? So generally, we think that once we get married, like for a woman, once a woman gets married, there will be no responsibility of her mother's family or father's family on her. Only the husband's family will be her duty. but not for Vishakha. For Vishakha, her own family and husband's family both are a responsibility, and even the husband is also childish. And after marriage, the elder sister of the husband also get divorced. So that is the no more responsibility. So multiple responsibilities, even those which don't actually belong to you, keep on crashing over your head in Vishakha. Right? This is something for Vishakha that needs to be understood. Along with that, Vishakha is also told as Krishmana, that is a Krishi Karyakarta, that is a farmer. So Vishakha person is very much like a farmer. He have to do like very strong, he have to do too much hard work to get some results. And his life is very much dependent on other factors such as rain, etc. So he have to do tirelessly hard work. And even after that tireless hard work, his life is dependent on other factors. He is not in control of his life. Right? But the person is born with great potential in anything. The person has great potential to sign in profession. The person has great potential to be everything. To shine in profession, to be the best father, the best mother, etc. But that will only come after much hard work and after losing many things in life. Right. So Vishakha goes with the story of that this is a person who can be very famous in their profession, but he doesn't want to work. It is a person who can be the best driver, but he don't want to drive. That kind of a personality is what Vishakha is. That is what Vishakha indicates. So the real thing for the Vishakha is to understand their potential, and work with it. Right? Okay. Some people also take Vishakha to be ruled by Indrapatni, Indrani. Right? Or some people take Indragni as a separate deity. Both the opinions are correct. In stories, there are few things which are associated with it. First of all, opulence. Or things available in plenty. Things available in the amount more than needed or more than asked for is signified by Vishakha. Great amount of fame and opulence is there in Vishakha. There is one thing with Vishakha. Vishakha will never commit a bad karma. Vishakha is very much spiritually conscious and self-aware. Vishakha will rarely do any bad deed. Vishakha is always worried about, is my karma going right, or am I not committing any bad karma, etc. So Vishakha person is an embodiment of someone who will always take the right path with or without guidance. Right? And this is a person generally who is, I already discussed this, right? It is a person who is not of this yuga. Generally, you know, Vishakha person you will find is a mismatch. He will be the quiet person in a family of talkative people. He will be a job person in the family of a businessman. Right? He will be a black person in the family of white people kind of a person. Right? Vishakha is quite of a mismatch. He doesn't belong to his family. Generally, with Vishakha, I say that it is born in a wrong family and is put into a bad circumstances, right? Vishakha indicates a person who believes in non-violence, but gets married to a person who is very violent. Vishakha indicates a person who is, very calm and peaceful, who got married to someone who like behaves and talks like a scoundrel kind of a person. Right? Specifically, the spouse of Vishakha is very beautiful and devoted. So if there is seventh lord or Venus in Vishakha, then the spouse is very beautiful, very devoted, very charming, and have all the good qualities that you can ask for in a spouse generally. Right. So here you have to, you know, like note this particular point that Vishakha, despite indicating a very beautiful and qualified spouse, will only give that when Vishakha is in the, Vishakha is the star tenanted by the seventh lord of Venus. When Vishakha is the birth star of the star tenanted by Moon, in that scenario, it can only indicate either the qualified spouse or beautiful spouse. Right? When seventh lord is there or Venus is there, both the qualities will be there. If only the Lagna or Moon is there, then it indicates your quality and not the quality of the spouse. So in that scenario, you will be a beautiful spouse or a qualified spouse, whereas your spouse may not be the beautiful or the spouse or beautiful or the qualified one. Right?
Sir, when moon is any moon is in any nakshatra, or say car, no, so we take that Karaka form, mother changes in day and night generally. So if that planet which is Karaka for mother in the particular nakshatra, should it indicate the quality of mother?
Yes, it should indicate the quality of the mother. Yeah, of course. Yes.
So I was thinking that, like, my mother died when I was, you know, 1 year or 1 year only, 1.5 years. So moon should be bad.
Where is the moon?
It is Vargottam in Scorpio.
Vargottam in?
Scorpio, Vrishik.
Nakshatra.
Anuradha Nakshatra Chaturspad.
Right, it is terrible. Anuradha Purushpada is terrible. Anuradha Purush Pada is not good.
That is why it seemed to me that the mother has very strong influence on the mind of the Jatak.
Yes, he is always. Mother keeps you in her womb. Whatever mother eats or thinks at the time of pregnancy, that will be your personality. That's and yeah, our Kanji, this leaving Gandhan aside, there are many nakshatras who are told akin to Gandhan. So Anuradha, Bharani, Anuradha, Bharani, and these nakshatras are very much akin to Gandhan. Okay, so these are not Gandhan signs, but akin to Gandhan. Right? Yeah. Okay. So now we should go for the remedies to Vishakha. This is one particularly very good remedy for all the nakshatras, actually. All the nakshatras, that is worth mentioning, and that is to plant a tree for the nakshatra, for that particular nakshatra. A tree can be planted for a particular nakshatra, and specifically for Vishakha. Specifically for Vishakha, the planting of tree, this particular remedy, is very highly recommended. Any tree you can take, although there is a particular tree for Vishakha. But that tree we will be teaching in the course and not telling you like only in the video. But still, any tree, planting a tree, at least one tree per year on your birthday, and taking care of that tree, highly recommended for Vishakha. Because worshipping Agni will be recommended as a remedy for Indrani in the Lord, such person should have at least, as a second remedy, such person should have at least one puja done per year at least. Right, so generally you should invite a pandit to come to your home and do a puja on Deepavali at least, or Satnarayan puja every 6 months or every 4 months or every 3 months, or like Satnarayan puja every Purnima or every Ekadashi should be done. It is a very good remedy. the second remedy. And the third remedy for Vishakha is to support those people, donate to those people, or give necessary items to those people who cannot afford it for themselves, be it orphaned children or those unfortunate elders who have been left by their family members, or you know, people suffering from disease, people suffering from some disability, giving them doing charities related to them, giving them the things they need is also a good remedy for Vishakha. These three things have it. Now, coming to the Pada results of Vishakha, as you must be knowing, every nakshatra has three padas. The first pada of Vishakha will be Libra nakshatra and Aries Namsha. Relationship is what Mars and Venus does. Learn it well versed in knowledge, specifically well versed in how to behave with people, well versed in behavior, sweet talking, learned, knowledgeable. Especially these people possess a very rare quality, like a rare quality of judging something, etc. Having very rare quality. Good leader, motivates everyone, supports everyone. This person is charismatic, dynamic. People are generally attracted to him. Famous and courageous, etc. The person gets married early. The marital life is good. Wife is beautiful, supportive. However, there is own share of ups and downs in marital life as well. But generally, it lasts despite all the fights and everything. The spark or compatibility between the couple is very good. Worth appreciating. If it is afflicted, then bad results will be more, of course. And if it is unafflicted or having good influence, then good results will be more. So whenever we tell a result, we tell it for both the positive and negative aspects of it. And when it is afflicted, negative aspects will be there. When it is having good planets, good results will be there. And accordingly, it will be there. Okay. Along with this, what else would we say?
Sir, in this, I'm sorry. In this pada, sun is debilitated in Rashi and exalted in Namsha.
Yeah, this is what I was about to say. That generally such people, till the time they live with their family, their life is very challenging. Sorry, till the time they live with their family, their life is very difficult. And they have to, struggle a lot even for the basic things. But by the time they become independent and start living life on their own separately from parents, luck favors them, profession supports them, they get money, wealth, respect, and everything in the society. They will be able to get property and vehicle by the age of 35, from 28 to 35 easily. They generally have male children, and they are generally well educated as well. Right? The native is generally beautiful in complexion, British in complexion. The person is intelligent, as I have already told you. The person will have long physique, it will be tall, will have long arms, big head, some accident mark on the head will also be there. The person will be miser and the person will not like to spend money, not on himself, not on his relatives also. And the person will be fierce, aggressive, short-tempered, and intelligent. Coming to Vishakha's second pada, it is Libra Rashi and Taurus Navamsha, but it is the 8th Navamsha. So, first of all, the person's life is filled up of unfortunate events. generally Vishakha Nakshatra second pada, the person leads a bad life, and everyone whoever comes to know of their life will be very surprised, as they never thought that this person really will be living that middle life. More than Uthke Dukaan Tiki Padawan. That is what happens with Vishakha Pada. The life is generally the person is generally unfortunate, right? And in those areas where he is blessed, he don't want to walk. The life is a story of unfortunate events and the person being ignorant about the qualities that he possesses. Along with this, the person gets good amount of money through inheritance. He is generally liked by the family member. People around him loves him so much. He have a huge circle, is generally famous, wealthy, rich, sweet spoken, like a bit fat as well, or say, you know, someone who is healthy. And generally gets the happiness of home, property, lands, and vehicles. The person is supposed to get problems related to water, such as diarrhea, etc. Problems related to coughing, breathing can also be there. The bone constitution is weak. The muscle constitution is good. The person is white in complexion. There are generally problems related to blood flow, such as hemoglobin or blood pressure, etc. Along with this, the person generally gets female child. The marital life is not very happy, and multiple partners are indicated. Okay. And the native have elevated shoulders, like bull, like Taurus Navamsha. So elevated shoulders, prominent neck, will enjoy pleasures. It's very much into sexual enjoyment, etc. So will enjoy pleasures, will have a coarse physique, will have a long and dark eyebrows, and he will be a polite speaker, will have a beautiful chest, and will have a bruised head. Vishakha third brother is Taurus Rashi and Jaimini Navamsha. Very good for business. Brilliant businessman. He can even sell a sunglass to a blind person. He only thinks of his benefit and don't think of the welfare of the world or society or people. His only target is to get the thing that he wants, to get it fulfilled and leave everything aside. But the person is a real devotee. And whoever he believes in, he is really devoted to them and to the rest of the world. He is only focused on getting what he wants. The person have good quality. Generally, always focused on doing good karmas only, generally refrains himself from doing bad karma. Despite having such great salesman skills, he refrains from doing bad karma. Motivated by good qualities, good person, spiritual, knowledgeable, well learned, generally have good amount of knowledge about textile or architecture, interested in astrology, vastu, etc. The person is will have many siblings. If not siblings, then will not be able to live at the place where he was born. Life will be generally unsettled. There will be many great changes in life, and by the time he gets accustomed to the previous change, a new change will be there waiting. Marital life is generally not good. There is fights, litigations between the couple, and the mentality of the couple doesn't match. The likes and dislikes are completely opposite. There is generally litigations with family members as well. The person may have a dislike towards food, or is generally dislikes a lot of food, and can have problems related to indigestion and problems related to hearing, speaking, or can have face problems, or problems related to appearance. Like the person can be ugly in appearance if it is afflicted. If not afflicted, then the person is beautiful, handsome, charming, like Mercury and Venus. generally gets a curly hair and faces difficulty in getting child. By after much tries can get one child, that two females, one female child. And the person have a very beautiful eyes. The person is generally very happy, and he knows how to remain happy all by himself. He don't need any other stimuli to remain happy, become happy or remain happy. Right? It is fair complexion, beautiful. The person is beautiful body. He is skillful, talented. And the person is fond of arts, is charitable, and is generally jocular, is of, joking tendency, is generally takes in a funny sense or in a light-hearted manner. Okay. Vishakha Pada 4 comes in Scorpio Rashi, Scorpio Navamsha. This person is a born leader. Famous, professional life is very good, people follow him, he rises to fame very quickly and very easily, generally in the profession related to secret keeping, CID etc, CID etc, or people who keep records of accounts in banks etc, it's generally in the trade of keeping secrets. The relationship with parents are not good, generally the relationship with mother is very bad. Indicates a person who may lose their parents early or have to get separated from their parents because of some reason or the other. Even the siblings, etc., don't support, and there is much misery on account of siblings as well. Right? But the person have a high, very high level of self-esteem, and he is all capable of doing everything all by his own without taking any other support. And the person is motivated, the person is valorous, the person is courageous, authoritative, achieves great success in life, generally have multiple properties, but suffers on the account of vehicle, generally someone who will do whatever he want and will not like to be guided or advised by someone, right? Generally loves a lady very deeply and loses many things because of that love. And if does love marriage, then complete disaster is there in the case of love marriage, right? And the person will always want to win and will always win even at the cost of others, right? The person gets children very quickly. Generally, male children he will have. The person himself is emotional, but will hide his emotional self. The person is very well versed in the art of torturing other and humiliating other, etc. And I think that's all. And the person is generally short in height. The person have a broad nose and broad lips. The person have a very broad forehead as well. The person have a strong body, likes to do exercise, with fair complexion, but also have a pet, also have a belly. That belly is not big in shape, but is very muscular. Very difficult to lose weight for such people. And their marital life may or may not be good, but whomever they advise on marital matters, their marital life is fairly bad. So they are technically a marriage failure. Okay. Generally, it is advised that if someone is born in Jeshtapur Pada, after marriage, don't visit them for at least 6 months. They can surely break your marriage, right? And I think that's it. Vishakha. And sorry, let's meet in the next class. That will be on the next nakshatra. I forgot the name of the nakshatra, but by the next class, I will remember the name of the nakshatra. Okay? Thank you.
Sir, at the end of the Vishakha nakshatra, just Scorpio 3 degree, ye Chandra ka param niche sthan. So what does this indicate about the quality of Vishakha?
So wo usme to keh diya na ki nayi naveli shaadi hogi uske baad jaoge to sab nipta dega. Now it is generally a person who is very inauspicious. Very inauspicious. It can, I told you, na, the person well versed in the art of torturing can do anything even at the cost of others. Usko race mein jeetne se matlab hai. Aap uske saath race mein kar rahe hain, aap truck se takra ke mar bhi jaate to farak nahi padta. Usi baat ko pujega maine trophy jeeti. Ye sab jo phal hai, ye moon ke param neech ki wajah se hai. तभी तो मैं मजाक कर रहा था, मैंने कहा मून नीच हो गया तो अगले दस प्रकार आप भूल गया भी याद रखे आऊंगा. राइट, नाउ वी हैव टू डू राधा. देखो विशाखा में राधा स्वामी और राधा में राधा अनु हो जाएगी क्योंकि लक्ष्मी की बड़ी बहन ज्येष्ठा आने वाली है. तो थोड़ा सा गेम चलेगा.
देयर इज अ स्मॉल, देयर इज अ like radha ji had two sakhis.
Yes.
And many sakhis, but the two closest to her are Vishakha and Lalita. Another name of Lalita is Anuradha. Maybe you know or maybe you're not, but
I started reading the new book from tomorrow, na, Krishna Yamal.
Acha.
Now I know everything about Radha. Krishna Yamal is a very good text.
That is Krishna Yamal Tantra, no?
Yeah, Krishna Yamal
Tantra.
Where Lalita Tripura Sundari helps Krishna get Radha mad at his love because Radha is not loving Krishna because for some reason or some purpose. So whatever, it is a good Tantra. That teaches you reversal of love and how to do it. Tantra is something that needs to be understood actually. Next class with next nakshatra, right?
Dhanyavaad. Mm-hmm.